just know that music, don't they?
NWO.
There's the NWO music that we're so familiar with. NWO Hollywood, the black and white, represented by Curt Hennig, and I'm sure Rick Rude to join him as well. Waiting for an appearance from the New World Order members, and here they come. What's Scott Hall doing with them?
Just lurking in the shadows, along with Vincent.
Drink the numbers, that's what the NWO black and white is all about. That's the foundation of the New World Order. Curt Hennig comes prepared this week. Scott Hall, Vincent, Rick Rude, not flying solo, not going it alone like he did last Monday night.
Boy, Kevin Nash really poured out his heart about this guy.
What a response it was by Scott Hall, almost just brushing off those heartfelt, emotional, personal comments that we heard earlier from his longtime Outsiders tag team partner, Kevin Nash.
After you did the interview with Nash and cameras were off, anything else you should know?
Bobby, I just have to tell you that I have never seen Kevin Nash in that mind frame, that mindset. Obviously, it's something that he was hurt very badly by not happening not just once, but twice. Just thinking that he had that association again with Scott Hall as they made the Wolfpack sign in the middle of the ring in Las Vegas, only to have Scott Hall stab him in the back once again.
Talking about heartfelt comments, how about what we heard moments ago from Arn Anderson?
Oh.
I mean, those were comments from a man who desperately would love to get back in the ring, but cannot. And I didn't realize until right there that when they call and they show him the sign of the four horsemen, that he desperately wants to be a part of it again, but because he cannot, Arn Anderson takes the other road. He wants to have nothing to do with it at all, and I can really understand that.
It's been his whole life, Tony.
Yes, it has.
Yeah, just admitting that he doesn't have the physical tools to compete any longer, and can you put it any better than the fact that there are groups and clubs and organizations all around the world that you can join? The difference is you have to earn the right to be a member of the Four Horsemen. And there's the people's champ, DDP Diamond Dallas Page, and the Wolfpack music doing.
What is this about? It, Diamond Dallas Page and Curt Hennig were to go one-on-one here, and, well, we saw that Scott Hall and Rude had come out with the black and the white. And KDog is making his way down the rampway area. Konnan is here. And remember, it wasn't too long ago right here on this program. He slapped the face of Curt Hennig. And Hennig has given chase. And now KDog and DDP giving the sign of being too sweet. We're going to have a match when we come back.
Oh, yeah.
Stay with us. We're back. There's a lot of people in the ring, and I think we'll get some clarification by David Pinzer, who's been talking to Mark Curtis. David, quickly, what's
going
on?
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee, Mark Curtis, has conferred with all the participants. This match has now become a tag team contest. Scott Hall and Curt Hennig to face Konnan and DDP.
Wow, how about that? To see a member of WCW and a member of NWO Wolfpack together, kind of an unprecedented move here, but DDP trusts Konnan. They seem to trust each other, and here we go against NWO Hollywood, and this is going to be a great one.
Well, maybe unprecedented, WCW and the NWO red and black of the Wolfpack. But Tony, think back about a month and a half ago when the New World Order red and black tried to recruit Diamond Dallas Page. We thought maybe he was going to join. Remember, it was just at that one moment where he might have taken the shirt off, when obviously his attention was diverted by Hollywood Hogan and Dennis Rodman. But the Wolfpack door always remained open to Diamond Dallas Page, in the words of Kevin Nash.
On the back of the head, outside, Diamond Dallas Page and Curt Hennig go. Two of the fine competitors in our sport. Two different philosophies, you know about it. Obviously, WCW and NWO Hollywood. But Diamond Dallas Page It seemingly is going to go through his entire life with taped ribs. Every time they heal, there's another chair at the hands of Hollywood Hogan or something, and he is swinging that cricket, a takedown, one Curt Hennig. And watch out. Try to swing a neck breaker again, and Hennig escaped from that one.
Swinging neck breaker, or maybe even some kind of a variation on the diamond cutter that time, the way that Hennig, very fortunately for him, rolled away at the last split second to avoid that contact.
Well, there's so many different ways he can put that diamond cutter on you. I've seen him get it on guys coming off the top rope, crisscrossing in the ring. He's quick with it and dangerous.
We have seen a profound impact made by NWO Hollywood here tonight in the persona, the black and white persona of one Bret the Hitman Hart. As Bret Hart came in, made a statement that he was going to take matters into his own hands. And Bret Hart has been the one undeniable force in this night. Bret Hart has turned into, in a one fell swoop, one of the most not only unpredictable, but most dangerous men in our sport. Back body drop. Just once again laying the table for members of NWO Hollywood to follow suit. Bret Hart has set the standard here tonight in many ways. Right now, though, Scott Hall, who just really listened as well as we did to the comments from his longtime close friend Kevin Nash, just completely blew him off in one fell swoop here. And you know, that's one of the reasons Konnan was also quick to get in the ring tonight, knowing that Scott Hall was there.
Has to be, Tony. We know that Kevin Nash is not here in the building. Maybe Konnan's a representative of Kevin Nash and the Wolfpack. That would seem to make sense. Scott Hall, the way he answered that heartfelt interview from last Monday with Kevin Nash, well, he credited Eazy-E, Eric Bischoff, and Hollywood Hogan with bringing him out of that personal financial crisis.
Not only that, let's not forget, as Konnan sets Scott Hall down, that Konnan wrestled in the very first match here tonight. So this is the second tour of duty for Konnan, but he's up to the task, and he and DDP controlling things in the ring right now. Hennig comes in to try to break things apart, and now they pair off.
He's going for the diamond cutter.
You're not kidding, but blocked that time. Going to try it again. Scott Hall has a pretty good solution for it there, doesn't he? Ben's down with him, but Scott Hall's wobbly. Oh, reaching out to an empty neutral corner.
Long way, pal.
Oh, and a flying forearm smash by DDP. Scott Hall needs a roadmap.
Konnan runs all the way the other way and runs over Scott Hall with a lariat. And now finally some order restored as DDP and Hennig are on opposite corners, allowing the two legal men to get back into it. Our feature bout this week on Thunder. It'll be our last Thunder until the 5th of August. Don't forget the Goodwill Games and the opening celebration on Saturday at 8.05 p.m. right after WCW Saturday night, and then 3 hours every night here on TBS. Here's a pickup now, or an attempt at a pickup. Could be his fallaway slam. That's what it's going to be. Oh, boy. A lot of power exhibited by Scott Hall there. That was a true deadlift right there, Mike.
Certainly was. Changed his mind almost in mid-move. Can't get him one way. Try another. Tag into Curt Hennig. Rolls through with that snapmare.
Snap the head over Hennig. Prevents now Konnan from getting over to the corner and bringing in one DDP. There's one of his patented moves, bringing that knee lift from Hennig.
You know what a good team that Hennig and Scott Hall are. But you can't really compare Nash and Hall. That was just a great team. Just a great team.
Mike, I thought you had a great comment. You thought it was maybe the greatest team ever, and I would echo those sentiments. They were literally when they wanted to be, and they often did things what we thought were the wrong way, and they had a lot of fun. They were very cocky and arrogant, but when they wanted to be, Hall and Nash were the greatest tag team ever.
Well, no one can deny that they did it their way as a tag team, and you can also never deny the success that they certainly had as a duo. Curt Hennig telegraphed the back body drop, momentary opening for Konnan, but then he cut him off in the middle of the ring.
Scott Hall measures Konnan, and that is on the rib cage. Those floating ribs in the lower back that time with the point of the elbow, and now a rear chin lock pulling up on Konnan and making sure that Konnan is looking right at his partner, DDP, who is reaching out, screaming some obscenities towards one Scott Hall and also encouraging Konnan as well.
Interesting tag team combinations in this matchup. We talked about DDP and Konnan with WCW and the NWO Red and Black represented. He also talked about Kevin Nash and Scott Hall being such a great tag team through the years. But if you think back, Curt Hennig and Scott Hall were a regular tag team even before Scott Hall joined forces with Kevin Nash. So they have quite a history as well.
Both men go down hard using the same maneuver. The running lariat that time, the back of the head hit the mat firmly, and both men are down, and Mark Curtis starts that 10 count.
You notice DDP still got his ribs wrapped. That's where Hogan put that chair in his back last week.
Come on, Hall.
This man's been hurt most of his career. And he's never asked for a day off or anything, has he?
No, and I wonder how he would feel to wrestle healthy. He probably wouldn't know what to do with himself.
No, wouldn't know. Just like you said, Konnan had a match earlier. You think he only gets in a fight once a day?
He made a tag to DDP.
And ribs and all.
Master of the Diamond Cutter comes in wailing away. Nailing a Hall. Now Hennig. DDP has to contend with the bit. Down goes Scott Hall. Here comes and there goes Curt Hennig.
And doing quite well despite being outnumbered 2-on-1. It's all Diamond Dallas Page at this point.
Back of the head. He got clubbed. He nails Scott Hall and turns around for Hennig to Decky. 1-2. Hit it. Was close to being over, but not yet.
Just got the shoulder up at the last split second.
The fat lady isn't singing yet.
Not yet, she's not.
She's just humming.
Top competitors, well, we're a long way away, I bet you. Top competitors giving it their all. Look at that drop kick. You talking about elevation from a standing position, just showing the athlete Curt Hennig is.
Oh, look at here, everybody in Oakland signaling they want to see the Diamond Cutter. They want to see DDP.
Right now, Hennig is in charge. Makes another lateral press, hooks a far leg, comes away with a close one again, but only a two.
Scott Hall wants to get right back in the thick of things, extending his hand across that top ring rope, trying to get the attention of Curt Hennig to make the tag.
All right, fans, stay right where you are. I'm told we got to take yet another commercial break. The tape machines are rolling. Whoa, watch out. Two count again. Should the match end during the break, we'll show you what happened on instant replay. If not, we're back live on Thunder here on TBS. Stay with us. Whoa. As intense, as physical a matchup as you'll ever find, and they're still going at it. DDP just wailing away with reckless abandon, not even realizing there was another man on the other end, and Scott Hall stopped that short. Pickup. Scott Hall may try another follow away, and he does. Raw power from Scott Hall of NWO Hollywood. Cover here. 1-2. Couldn't keep him down.
During the commercial break, it's been all Curt Hennig and Scott Hall executing a perfect tag team strategy. They've cut off the ring and totally dominated with double team tactics against DDP. Now the abdominal stretch applied. And Curt Hennig extends the hand to add a little leverage to the abdominal stretch.
And don't forget that ever dangerous Rick Rude outside the ring along with Vincent.
Along with Vincent. Strength in numbers, and so far with the advent of what has gone down tonight with Bret the Hitman Hart, as dangerous, more dangerous than they've ever been. Especially Bret Hart, who's actually in many ways gone psycho on us here tonight.
Now, Bret Hart said that he wanted to be known as a major player in World Championship Wrestling. And over the course of the past couple of weeks, he has certainly elevated his status in WCW as well as all of the NWO factions. He is a part of that NWO Hollywood group that is making a statement.
Extra leverage. Mark Curtis there to see it, but what can he do about it? The damage has been done. Desperation, hip toss by DDP, and injured abdominal muscles as well, obviously. They are working on the ribcage, on the kidney area, and notice how Hennig took his time, allowed DDP to expend some energy, crawling all the way to the other corner to grab him by the nape of the neck, just in the nick of time.
That's the mark of a veteran. That's a man who knows that ring.
Into a neutral corner, just an open target for Curt Hennig.
Gave him that faint hope, cuts off the ring, and then right back to the offensive attack. Good quick tags. It's a reason they've dominated this tag matchup for the better part of the past 5 or 6 minutes.
That's what they've done, and DDP has been their target. Into the corner, no place to go. That rocks the head back, certainly does. Rude looks on from down low, but Scott Hall and Curt Hennig are in control here.
That last lariat by Scott Hall executed with such intensity in the corner that it took Diamond Dallas Page off of his feet.
Sleeper hold applied after all of this, so sleeper hold is on. How about that?
Konnan's got to get in to save him, or he's got to make him, he's got to push Hall back into that corner.
Yeah, Konnan needs to do a, some sort
be
of...
Be Konnan.
To be Konnan, or at least to try to jump in here and stop this. Onto DDP! Trying to get the sleeper on, doesn't really have the other arm hooked, but he's hooked. Ah. And up belly to back by Scott Hall. My goodness.
But see, that's DDP. He didn't make an effort to make a tag. He just wants to fight. He just got out of that, slapped the sleeper on the man himself. He could have gone tag.
It was reactionary. Yep. There is no question. The reaction to try to put a hold on and not make a tag. Well, of course, wasn't long ago, 15 minutes ago. 15 minutes ago was going to be a singles match. Didn't expect to have a tag team match. Fans, we're going to go overtime here tonight if need be. We'll stay to the conclusion. Oh! And a tag has been made. So well, stay
fresh,
with us.
A fresh Konnan.
Konnan in. Hit it down.
Oh! Oh! Rolling clothesline. Wolfpack on fire now.
Roots up.
Interference from outside.
Some diamond cutters, but really hit the wrong man. And Hennig, along with Scott Hall, wins our feature bout here on Thunder. Don't forget 2 hours of WCW Saturday night, and we'll see you live on Monday from Salt Lake City on Nitro. Have a good night, everybody.